Hi guys, it's Ms. Clark. I'm an 8th grade ELA teacher here at Small Middle School. I recently reached out to Ms. Sylvia to see if I could do a book talk for you guys on her living room library site, and she agreed, so here I am. Thank you, Ms. Sylvia, for this opportunity. I don't know how many of you guys are aware that April is National Poetry Month. And I know, you guys are probably sitting there going, why are you here to recommend poetry to me? That's what my teacher makes me read when they want to torture me. First off, you guys don't actually hate poetry as much as you think you do, because you're already familiar with it in your songs, with your lyrics. If you take away the music, you have poetry with the lyrics right there. So you do like poetry. On top of that, there are books that are written in verse form and poetry that are beautifully written, and I'm here to recommend one of them for you guys today. It's called Brown Girl Dreaming by Jacqueline Woodson, and it is all about the author Jacqueline Woodson's experiences growing up as an African-American girl in the 1960s and the 1970s. What's really cool about it is that in the 1960s and the 1970s were when the civil rights movement was really going strong, and the African Americans were finally winning and succeeding and achieving those equal opportunities that they had been hoping for years. And so she talks about that. And then it's also really cool because she was born in the north part of the United States. She traveled and lived down in the south for years and then lived back in the north again. So she has both sides, both perspectives on it. And even some of the stuff about living in the South, when she describes it, it struck home with me because I've grown up here in Texas in the South. And when she describes the sounds, it's all stuff that I was familiar with. She writes it so beautifully, and she manages to make it where it can resonate with everybody, no matter how they grew up or where they grew up, because throughout it all, she's just trying to find a home and find her place in the world, her place in her family, what makes her special. In the poem, she talks about how she has two older siblings, and she talks about what makes each of them special before she starts thinking that she has probably something too, and she tries to find it. I strongly recommend this book. Even if you don't really like poetry, the poems aren't hard to understand. It's a memoir written in poetry, so it flows really well. It's very, very beautiful. It can be a quick read, because if you think about it with poems, and if you look, the poems don't take up all the page. It has less words than a regular book would. So even though it might look big and intimidating, it's really not that. And there have been so many different poems in this book that afterwards I just have to stop and just take a moment, because they're so pretty, and they resonate with me so much. So that's what I want to recommend to you guys today. It's a book called Brown Girl Dreaming by Jacqueline Woodson. Check it out. I hope you guys do. If you do, feel free to send me an email or stop by sometime and say that you read it and that you got the recommendation from me on here, because I'd love to talk to you guys about it more. Again, thank you, Ms. Sylvia, for this opportunity. Bye, guys.